Today we have 4 minutes of advanced box building tips. We finished the serpentine conversion in the van. What if it doesn't run? And I have a base wars update. People are saying EXO took the lead because he's working on a baffle board. And Mark gave up on cars completely. And shoes. He's over here putting out a barefoot home theater video. But first, learn how you could win a Tesla Model S Plaid from today's sponsor, Omaze. Omaze gives away one-of-a-kind prizes and experiences while donating to chosen charities across the world. Right now, you have a chance to win a Tesla Model S Plaid. Enter for your chance to be among the first to own a Tesla Model S Plaid, the fastest and most advanced production car ever made. The Tesla Model S Plaid is an all-electric vehicle with a 390-mile range, three electric motors totaling 1,220 horsepower. Put me in the giveaway. I want with a quarter mile time under 10 seconds and a 0 to 60 in under 2 seconds. 22 speakers, 960 watt stereo system. Enter for your chance to win at omaze.com/SCA. The charity connected to this giveaway is Reverb. Reverb partners with musicians, festivals, and venues to green their concerts while engaging fans face-to-face at shows to take environmental and social action. Their work makes a real positive impact on the environment, including the elimination of 3 million plus single-use water bottles at concerts, supporting 2,000 family farmers, elevating the work of 4,000 local and national nonprofits, and eliminating over 180,000 metric tons of CO2 through their Music Climate Revolution campaign. To potentially win the Tesla Model S Plaid and support Reverb, a great cause, go to omaze.com/SCA. Link in the video description. Thank you, Omaze, for sponsoring today's video. Now go win yourself a Tesla. Roll the dumb intro. Amplified is produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc. and NVX. Buy genuine Soundman iPad dash kits at soundman.co and find high-quality car audio equipment at nvx.com. We are also sponsored by U.S. Alternators, Down for Sound Shop, and Audio Control. The first subwoofer box building tip I'd like to share with you guys is how to countersink this hole. You buy yourself a CNC router and you let the machine cut your woofer baffle. You cheap ass bitch. What do you get when you put one Vajay Smell audio woofer in the same box with one Cockford Ballsgate woofer with no divider? Let me think about it. Roll the next tip. Now what we're going to do next, we're going to put the woofer on this side. And as you can see, we have some masking tape here to prevent the woofer from getting marred up by this here drill. Oh fuck, I fucked it up. Just kidding. You ain't gonna learn this shit on that other car audio channel, let me tell you that much. Bump a lot of puss. Roll the next clip. All right, look at that. If you look at that, then you're gonna go like this. Okay, I didn't film the entire box build because I slapped these bitches out in about 10 minutes each. I'm making the big money, baby. Look at this. The next tip is how to make a double shotgun barrel port system. This thing's gonna bump so hard, people are gonna think shotgun's going off. This box is for a 55 Chevy hot rod, brand new Chevy engine, custom chassis, the whole nine. And this is for I believe a 55 or 57 Nomad. The next question people ask that I'd like to address is how do you get so much work for prestigious cars? How are you building such high-end boxes for these people? How do you keep it coming? For my next subwoofer box building tip that you will never see on another car stereo channel, I'm gonna teach you how to take a prong on a T-nut and bend her down. Gonna give her a bend. Then we're gonna take some tin snips like this. And I'm gonna give it a snip a do like this. Oh dang, landed in the box. Over here we have a hole that's close to the wall. So we could still use a T-nut on her. Then I like to clamp the T-nut into position with my Nipex because it has uniform clamping pressure, okay? Some people think this is a crescent wrench. What are you crescent wrenching your T-nuts in? I'm over here trying to watch Mark's dumb video, getting hungry. His bare feet look like two giant turkey breast fillet cutlet. Turkey breast cutlets.
Damn.
Shit. Yeah, this is where it gets into some real box building tips, because see, this box has to actually fit a car. Mark Zuckerberg's over here building YouTube boxes that don't go in anything. So if he runs into a position where he needs a hole in the edge, he could just make the box bigger. And he doesn't have to worry about it because the box doesn't have to fit a vehicle. You see, over here we're putting car stereos in actual cars. Look at that turd, huh? This is the positive and negative terminal bolt. Oh no, look what you did. You dropped it, you idiot. Alright, you fucking bitch, here's where we left off. We got these brackets on. Right now I just test fit the red alternator on my S10 bracket. I texted Dan from US Alternators, he's gonna get us another one of those so I can put that one over here. I can't put that one back over here until we take the Gonzo snorkelet off and remove the under tube. What the fuck is that shit popping out at the bottom? I gotta put it off to the side. It's gotta pop out the side, pussy. So I don't know what I'm gonna do. I have to get the water pumplet on. I gotta press this dumb pulley on with the dumb Harbor Freight Pittsburgh pulley remover / installer. We're missing a smog pump. How the hell am I gonna get this baby to pass smog? Insert the pilot end of the appropriate screw installer through the pulley and thread into the pump shaft until screw installer bottoms. I gotta bottom it into the shaft. And tighten this fucking bitch this way. I don't think it's gonna go, baby. See, it just unloosens the other one. Oh, I broke it. It's just turning the bullshit. Oh, now it unloosened the fucking thing again. You guys always say unloosen, now I'm saying it. And now you got people leaving stupid comments saying I'm an idiot. Bitch, I know what unloosen means. I know the proper terminology. For radiator fluid. For instance. You're gonna spoil it for everybody. The point is to say it wrong so all the young kids say it wrong, and then we know what the joke is. When you say unloosen the radiator fluid cap. And now you spoiled it. Stupid ass dumb bitch. I think it might be going. I can't tell if it's going or not. Can you guys tell? Leave a comment, let me know if you can tell. Sweating over here, sweating my fucking dick off. Fucking with this bullshit. It's Sunday. On a Sunday. Something's moving. Something's moving somewhere. It's gonna pop off. I'm gonna tighten it. It's gonna be like, ping. I just think we should all understand what re-tighten the radiator fluid cap means. Because it was tight and you unloosened it. Now you gotta re-tighten it. You dumb bitch. Now you fucking... I think it went on, you dumb bitch. Ooh. Now we gotta remove the puller body. Okay, this is the puller body. We got a thrust washer. And then we got this dumb little piece of shit here. Okay. Yeah, baby, we did it. We goddamn did it.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
Look at that, you son of a fat whore. Listen to her spin. Good job, Pittsburgh pulley remover and installer set. All right, now we're gonna install the new water pump-a-later. We're gonna slap the gaskets on like this. Okay, I'm gonna hold all four of these screws and slap the gasket on. And then we're just gonna right onto the, you know what I mean? Get up on here, you dumb little hillbilly hooker. You hillbilly bitch. Okay, this one's gonna go like this. Oh no, I almost dropped a screw and the gasket almost fell off, you dumb idiot. You stupid piece of... Oh, now look, you dropped this. Now we don't have the right tools here. You see? We have the wrong bullshit. Now I gotta hold this up with one hand like this. You didn't prepare correctly. Now you drop that. Okay, you're making it hard on me because I'm trying to film a dumb video because of you. If I wasn't filming the dumb video, I wouldn't be doing this with my fucking 8-inch ratchet. Look it. Look it. It's gonna work anyway, huh? Because now look. It's gonna work anyway because that's what we do here. We put the shit on and we hurry up and get it on. It may not look like I'm going quick, but I have other shit to do. People are like, where's the next bass video? Bitch, I'm doing more than one thing here. This wire was coming off the factory alternator. And I have some wires coming out of the new alternator. I'm assuming that'll all hook up to the new PCM module. Get this out of the way now. We're gonna take a peek in here. This is Rafa's mom's church belt.
You like it, huh?
Now I'm assuming this is the wrong size. Go up here, over here, and around here. And then we're gonna go here. Move around like this. Is this gonna goddamn fit? You son of a whore. I didn't think it was gonna fit because I went ahead and ordered the serpentine pulley kit that came with the idlers and all that for the wrong vehicle. Because we're working with three different vehicles worth of bullshit here. But look at that, huh? Oh, we're gonna pull the pulley. Oh, yeah. Look at her go, boss. Can't believe my eyes. After all this time and all this work, the EXO doesn't even have any alternators yet. This amount of work would have caused Mark to have a nervous breakdown. No! What if it leaks? I just gotta make sure that pulley's all the way tightened. What if it kicks the belt off right when I start it? When I start it, I gotta make sure that new fuel line doesn't leak. Or else we're gonna explode. This all started from this stupid YouTube channel I used to watch. I'm not one to talk bad about anybody, so I won't name any names. But I don't know if he does it anymore, but B is for Build used to say, uninstall. I'm gonna uninstall the brake caterpillar. Bitch, the word is remove. The word you're looking for is you're gonna remove it. You're not gonna uninstall.
Unwelding the car in half. Rewelding the car.
Upgrade your vehicle's charging system with a high output alternator from US Alternators. visit usalternators.com. Down for Sound is an authorized dealer and offers the best prices on the brands they carry with the fastest shipping in the industry. Go to downforsoundshop.com. Audio Control has what you need to make your good stereo system sound better. Take a look at Audio Control's full line of equalizers, line drivers, digital signal processors, and more at audiocontrol.com. And instead focus on serving the needs of their communities. Communities? Sign me up. Look at this. What do we have here, Oh, dang. Non-stick titanium scissors. This is from Juno Cat 5. This might be a little late since you're already past sound dampening the bass fan, but these scissors are killer on butyl rubber and VHB tape because neither material can stick to the titanium. It's a miracle of modern. I got something for Fido too. The bass fan is looking great and the vlogs are still the best thing to watch on YouTube. The other bass fan builds are whack. That's what I said. I agree with that. Oh, look at this. Lil Fido. Fido. Dang, thanks, Juno Cat. Shit. What the fuck's this, What the fuck is this, you fucking bitch? 12 by 2 by... Oh, no. Is this an iPad kit? Oh, no. Oh, what do they want? Oh, it's a picture frame. This is a picture frame of Rafa's ass cheeks. Because it looks like he's trying to shoplift 2 loaves of wheat bread out of Walmart down the back of his dickies. Look at it.
You like it, huh?
I'll shoplift 2 slices of Wonder Bread down the back of my Levi's if it means free lunch, so I can afford some top-notch radiator fluid for the bass fan. Fido, give me a noise. Roll the unboxing clip. Oh, shut up, you dumb little bitch. God dang, let me read my letter. All right. This is from Fildo T. Baggins. Thank you for the years of entertainment. It's been swell. I haven't seen Rafa around much lately, so I thought you would enjoy this photo of 2 loaves of wheat bread sticking out a bag in a warm embrace. Mrs. T. Baggins and I have enjoyed every series, even the shitty Dash Mod videos. The bass fan has been fun. Is it done yet? No, it's not done, you dumb bitch. Thanks, Fildo. Shit. I gotta get this wiener off of here. Oh my goodness, that sucker's on there like a son of a fucking bitch. Shoot. If we don't hook this up, we won't have a heater. What am I gonna do without a heater? Smoking bowl, taking a shit, reading a dumb comment. Dude said, where have you been? Again. And when I read these comments that ask where I've been, I'm still here. I'm sitting here reading the comment. Where the fuck do you think I've been? I put out a video and people start asking, I'm taking a shit, is what I'm... Can I take a shit? And my laptop broke. My laptop's not allowed to break? My 2012 MacBook Slow took its last dump on my lap. I had to bury it. Then I realized I had some files on there. I had to unbury it. The fuck do you mean, where have I been? Mitch? Can you see where I am? We're sending her up, Fido. We're gonna have to unloosen this unit here. Get out of here, you fucking cunt. Oh, something's in my eye. All right, now it looks like I'm replacing this OEM metal gasket with a cork gasket. What if it leaks? I had to drop the oil pan to get the timing chain cover back on. I replaced the timing chain and the cover gasket, so I had to uninstall the oil pan. Now I'll have to replace the gasket and unremove it back up there. Roll the clip. What's going on? It's going on. The fucking dumpster. What the fuck? Oh no. This isn't working out very swell. You know. Where's my missing nut, dude? Oh, better not have fell into the oil pan. It's in the oil pan, guys. I have another Base Wars update. Mark's views continue to go down ever since he discovered the DIY guy is his real father. And he's convincing him to go to the limp side. And he went. And his views are going down because he's making barefoot home theater videos while the DIY audio guy remakes all of his how to make a subwoofer box videos. No! And they're better. No! Alright, we got the oil pan on. We're gonna put some of this penis oil in here. Get some of that penis oil. Get into the zone, my butthole zone. Can I help you? She's spilling. Look at this little Honda power steering pump reservoir. What do you think of that, huh? We're gonna put some Prestone in here. I know this looks like penis oil, but this isn't. Ooh. Now get down on in there. We're damn close, Fido. The thing I'm worried most about is if that fuel line that I made leaks. Because that would suck, because it's so buried in there. And if the alternator post arcs on the fuel line and the fuel line leaks, it's gonna ignite the fumes. I got this radiator fluid at O'Reilly's. Bites my cock. Ow! All right, I think she's ready. The battery's fully charged. So far, we don't have any electrical fires. What if it doesn't run? Let me know if it blows up. I don't know if the fuel pump is pumping.
please.
Well, shit. I told you it might run.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
Purchase industry-leading iPad dash kits from the originator at soundman.co. Your car deserves the best. Update your car with an iPad dash kit from soundman.co. Find high-quality car audio gear at nvx.com. NVX is committed to audio quality and innovation. Their high-end car audio components are rated accurately, and they've been proven to perform since 2011. Try NVX at nvx.com.